हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स 2. आई एम हितेश मंगलानी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस टॉपिक दैट इज डाइवर्जेंस एंड कर्ल ऑफ चैप्टर वेक्टर कैलकुलस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस डाइवर्जेंस. सो डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ वेक्टर फील्ड divergence of vector field F is denoted by DIVF or del dot F. Okay, so del dot F. So what is del? Del is vector differential operator, which is defined as I del by del X plus J del by del Y plus K del by del Z. Dot. What is F? It is vector which is given by F1 I cap plus F2 J cap plus F3 K cap. So here if we take dot product of these two vectors, so it will be del F1 by del X plus del F2 by del Y plus del F3 by del Z. So this is divergence of vector F. So here you can see that divergence of F is scalar quantity. Clear? So divergence of F is scalar quantity. Is scalar quantity. Now, if divergence of F is zero, if divergence of F is equal to zero, then vector field F is called solenoidal. So if divergence of F is equal to zero, then vector field F is called solenoidal. Now let us discuss examples related to divergence. So first example, determine whether the vector field F y square I plus 2 xyj minus z square k is solenoidal at point 1 to 1. So to prove this vector field as solenoidal vector field, first of all we will have to find out divergence of F, which is given by del dot F. Okay, so which is del by del X of F1, here F1 is y square, okay, plus del by del Y of F2, here F2 is 2xy, plus del by del Z of F3, here F3 is minus Z square. Now if we take partial differentiation of Y square with respect to X, then it will be 0 because here Y is constant. Now here if we take partial differentiation of 2XY with respect to Y, so it will be 2X because derivative of Y with respect to Y is 1, and here if we take partial differentiation of minus Z square with respect to Z, then it will be minus 2Z. So this is divergence of vector field F. Now we have to find out divergence of vector field F at point 1 to 1. So at point 1 to 1. So for that purpose, we will replace x by 1, y by 2 and z by 1 in this. So if we replace x by 1, y by 2 and z by 1 in this, so it will be 2 minus 2, so it will be 0. Now we have already discussed if divergence of vector field is 0, then that vector field is called solenoidal. Therefore, we can say that vector field F is solenoidal at point 1, 2, 1. Now let us discuss second example, that is find the value of the constant lambda such that the vector field defined by F that is equal to 2x square y square plus z square I cap plus 3xy cube minus x square z j cap plus lambda x y square z plus xy k cap is solenoidal. So here it is given that this vector field is solenoidal. So when vector field is said to be solenoidal, if divergence of that vector field is 0. So here it is given that divergence of F is equal to 0. Now, what is divergence of f? It is del by del x of f1, and here f1 is 2x square y square plus z square plus del by del y of f2. So here f2 is 3xy cube minus x square z, okay, plus del by del z of f3. Here f3 is lambda x y square z plus xy, and that is equal to 0. So if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to x, then it will be 4x y square, because here derivative of x square will be 2x and y square will be as it is, plus here derivative of z square with respect to x will be 0, because z is constant whenever we are taking partial differentiation with respect to x, okay. Plus, now partial differentiation of this function with respect to y, so now x and z will be constant, so here derivative of y cube will be 3y square, so 3y square into 3x, so it will be 9xy square, okay, and here x and z are constant, therefore derivative of this term will be 0, okay, plus, now we will take partial differentiation of this function with respect to z, so now x and y will be constant, so here lambda xy square will be as it is, and derivative of z with respect to z is 1, and here x and y are constant, therefore derivative of this term will be 0, clear? So this is equal to 0. Therefore, this is 4xy square plus 9xy square, okay, so we can say that lambda xy square is equal to minus 13xy square, okay, so here xy square cancel out, therefore value of lambda will be minus 13, clear? So here we have to find the value of lambda such that this vector field is solenoidal. So value of lambda will be minus 13 such that this vector field f will be solenoid. Now let us discuss curl. So curl of vector field f is denoted by curl f or del cross f. So now we have to find out the cross product of del and vector f. So it will be determinant of I, j, k, del by del x, because ith component of this del is del by del x, then jth component of this del is del by del y, and kth component of del is del by del z, and ith component of vector f is f1, jth component of vector f is f2, and kth component is f3. So we have to take determinant of this. So if we take determinant of this, then it will be I cap in bracket del f3 divided by del y, okay, minus del f2 divided by del z, minus j cap in bracket del f3 divided by del x minus del f1 divided by del z, plus k cap in bracket del f2 divided by del x minus del f1 divided by del y. So here we can see that curl of vector field f is vector quantity. So curl of vector field f is vector quantity. Clear? Now, if curl of vector field f, then vector field f is called irrotational vector field. Okay? So, if curl of vector field f is equal to 0 vector, then that vector field is called irrotational vector field. Now let us discuss examples related to this. Find the divergence and curl of V, which is xyz in bracket x comma y comma z. So here, first of all, this vector V can be written as x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Clear? Because this is vector representation. So here V vector will be x square yz I cap plus xy square z j cap plus xyz square k cap. Now here we have to find the divergence and curl of this vector. So first of all, we will find out divergence of V, which is given by del dot V, which is del by del x of V1, that is ith component of vector V. So it is x square y z plus del jth component of vector V, that is x y square z plus del by del z of kth component of vector V, that is x y z square. So here partial differentiation of this function with respect to x will be 2xyz, because derivative of x square is 2x and yz will be as it is. Same way, partial differentiation of this function with respect to y will be again 2xyz, because derivative of y square with respect to y will be 2y and x and z will be as it is. Plus partial differentiation of this function with respect to z will be again 2xyz, because derivative of z square will be 2z and xy will be as it is. Therefore 2xyz plus 2xyz plus 2xyz, so it will be 6xyz. Therefore divergence of vector V will be 6xyz. Now we will find out curl of vector V. So curl of vector V is given by del cross V, so it will be determinant of I, j, k, del by del x, del by del y, del by del z. And here ith component of a vector V, which is x square y z. Then jth component of vector V is x y square z, and kth component of vector V is x y z square. Clear? So this will be I in bracket del by del y of x y z square minus del by del z of x y square z. Clear? Then minus j del by del x of x y z square minus del by del z of x square y z plus k cap in bracket del by del x of x y square z minus del by del y of x square y z. Now if we simplify this, that means partial differentiation of this function with respect to y, so it will be xz square, okay, minus partial differentiation of this function with respect to z, so it will be minus xy square. Clear? Okay, now here again partial differentiation of this function with respect to x, so it will be yz square. Okay, here I cap minus j cap in bracket, here it will be yz square minus x square y, okay, plus k cap in bracket, here partial differentiation of this function with respect to x will be y square z minus partial differentiation of this function with respect to y will be x square z. So here we can simplify this. Here we can take x common, here we can take y common, and here we can take z common. So this will be curl of V. Answer of curl of V will be, here taking x common, so it will be x in bracket z square minus y square I cap, clear? Then minus, here y is common, so y in bracket z square minus x square j cap, plus here z is common, so z in bracket y square minus x square k cap. So this is the answer of curl of given vector v. Now let us discuss next example related to this. Show that vector f, which is y square minus z square plus 3yz minus 2x I cap plus 3xz plus 2xy j cap plus 3xy minus 2xz plus 2z k cap is both solenoidal and irrotational. So to prove this vector f as a solenoidal vector, we will have to show that divergence of vector f equal to 0. So here first of all we will find out divergence of this vector f, which is given by del by del x of ith component of vector f, that is y square minus z square plus 3yz minus 2x plus del by del y of jth component of vector f, that is 3xz plus 2xy plus del by del z of kth component of vector f, that is 3xy minus 2xz plus 2z. So this is del dot f, divergence of f. So if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to x, so y and z will be constant, therefore derivative of first two terms will be 0 and derivative of this term will be 0, so it will be minus 2 into 1, because derivative of x with respect to x is 1, so it will be minus 2 plus. Now if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to y, then x and z are constant, therefore derivative of first term will be 0 and derivative of second term will be 2x, because derivative of y with respect to y is 1, okay. Now if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to z, then x and y are constant, so derivative of first term will be 0, okay, and derivative of second term will be minus 2x, because here derivative of z with respect to z is 1, plus derivative of 2z will be 2, because derivative of z with respect to z is 1. So here 2 cancel out, 2x, 2x cancel out, so it will be 0. Therefore, we know that whenever divergence of f is 0, then that vector field is called solenoidal. Now we will have to show that curl of vector field f equal to 0 vector, because then and then vector field f will be irrotational. So for that purpose, first of all here we will have to find out curl f, which is given by I, j, k, del by del x, del by del y, del by del z, and here ith component of vector f, which is y square minus z square plus 3yz minus 2x, okay, then jth component is 3xz plus 2xy, and kth component is 3xy minus 2xz plus 2z, okay. Now if we take determinant of this, then it will be I in bracket, okay, del by del y of 3xy minus 2xz plus 2z minus del by del z of 3xz plus 2xy, okay, minus j cap del by del x of 3xy minus 2xz plus 2z, okay, minus del by del z of y square minus z square plus 3yz minus 2x plus k cap del by del x of 3xz plus 2xy minus del by del y of y square minus z square plus 3yz minus 2x. Okay? Now if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to y, then it will be 3x. Then here if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to z, so it will be 3x, because here derivative of this term will be 0 because x and y are constant. So here it will be 3x minus 3x. Okay? Same way, if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to x, so here it will be 3y minus 2z. 3y minus 2z. And here if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to z, then it will be minus 2z plus 3y. Okay? Here 3y minus 2z, and here minus 2z plus 3y, but here again it is minus sign, so it will become plus 2z minus 3y, and here 3y minus 2z. Okay, now here if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to x, then it will be 3z plus 2y, and here if we take partial differentiation of this function with respect to y, then it will be 2y plus 3z. Okay, but here it is minus sign, so it will be minus 2y minus 3z. So if we simplify this, then curl of vector field F will be 0i plus 0j plus k. So it will be 0 vector. So whenever curl of vector field F is 0 vector, then that vector field F is called irrotational. Therefore, in this example, divergence of vector field F is 0 and curl of vector field F is 0 vector. Therefore, vector field F is both solenoidal and irrotational. So, in today's lecture, we have discussed about divergence and curl. Thank you for watching this lecture. I will see you in the next lecture.